All right, guys, today we're tuning in this pavement street stock. It's got a 12-to-1, 355 in it, dart platinum cylinder head, solid roller deal. Looking to turn it somewhere in the 7,000 RPM area. It's got a Muncie 4-speed in it with first and second deleted, so it's just a 2-speed now, which is typical for this. This is actually a good friend of mine's car, thus the name on the quarter panel there. We sponsor him some stuff, so excited to get this thing running and see what we can make with it power-wise. These typically make in the like high 300-400 area, depending on how hard we're going to turn it. Like I said, I think we're going to turn this thing around 7, I'm going to dive into it. It's got a quick fuel carburetor on it that's new, so we're going to have to do some jetting work, I am sure. Usually they're close, but they always require a little bit of love, so going to get that done and see what we can make. So here's a before and after. We made 378 in the beginning, 378 horsepower, 330 foot-pounds of torque. We ended up with 420, 354. Here's the differences in the curves. It's a little choppy up there. Those spikes are just from the attack signal dropping out occasionally. But made peak power out at 6,800, right where we were thinking about that 7,000 mark. So original jetting was in the like high 10s, low 11s. So we leaned this thing out to that 12.2, 12.5 area. The curve, the air fuel curve, is a little inconsistent through the RPM range, so we kind of had to pick a happy medium there. Ended up with what we thought was a lot of ignition timing. The timing pointer actually ended up being incorrect, which was part of the reason why the numbers were so low to begin with. I put 30 degrees in it for the first hit, which was really 28 degrees. We ended up with what the timing light tells us is 38, but is really somewhere in the 35 degree area. It's got an adjustable pointer on it, but the pointer, one of the Allens, is stripped, so we'll have to fix that later. Anyway, definitely a good power increase. They were running this thing at 36 degrees before, so I'm going to say they were probably in the right at the 400 mark, so we picked up at least 20 wheel from the last time it was on track, but it was a different carburetor at that point. But that's it for this one. I'm going to get it off of here and move on to the next.